Toss will receive United States' 200th commemorative coin. The referee, Mike Pereira, from the Pacific Coast Athletic Association, sends them on their way. Goes to Williams. Oh, he got a big hole off the wind. And comes across the 40 and out to near the 43-yard line. Odom, Davis, Wright, Daniel, Sims, Williams are the big people up front offensively for the Gators. In the backfield at quarterback, Kerwin Bell. Wideouts are Simmons and Mills. Williams, the fullback, and of course, the heralded freshman Emmett Smith is the I-back, or the deep man out of the I formation. And from the 43, first down, Bell back to throw it. Little play action and goes big with it downfield, and the receiver, number 14, got tangled up.
If he would have stayed on his feet, he would have had to drift back to the outside to make the catch.
And we go to second and 10 now from the 43 as Bell this time gives it to Emmett. No, it's Williams. Anthony Williams. Everybody's got their eye on Smith. And defensively for UCLA, Lodish, Toomey, Waller, they're the big down people. And Lodish is playing in place of Glasser, who's hurt. Waller is also banged up. Lake, Johnson, Norton, Hummel, the backers. Secondary is a good one for the Bruins, as the world knows. Henley, Dial, Washington, and Price. It is a first down for the Gators, just inside the UCLA 47, and this time they go to Smith, the 5'10", 200-pound freshman. It is second down and 3.5 to 4 as Kerwin Bell rolls, loops it to the sidelines, and simply throws a bad pass. Third down and about 4.
Come on, AG! Get up here!
And inside to Anthony Williams, and he's cut down at the 40.
Yeah.
Now he's got to deal with it. They're going to go for it on fourth down. And a good 3. And it off. It is Smith. And Smith is close. And the Bruins take over now. Good field position, resting out near their 38. Eric Ball is the tailback or I-back, and Eric's got the ball playing in place of Justin Green. And I'll tell you right now, if you're playing on Anthony Richards, Kidder, Cornish, Meyer, Warnick, the big people for the Bruins up front. Charles Arbuckle is out, still having trouble with a knee. Wide people are Willie Anderson and Paco Craig. Aikman, the quarterback. James Primus does start at fullback, though he's dinged up, and Ball, the tailback. It is second down and 4 for the Bruins. They move the tight end, Anthony. And give the ball. First down, UCLA at the Florida 40. And he's coming back next year. Whistle stop him. Mike Pereira. The
dead ball, false start, offense, first down.
The officials, a combination of the PCAA and the Southwest Conference. The defensive alignment, down linemen and linebackers for Florida. Charlton and Richardson, the two backers, you want to watch them. They can tell you pretty much where the play's going today, I think, because one drops and one chases. It is first down, UCLA 15, as they move it. Whiteouts on second down and 14. For the play action, they tip it out there to Anderson. Anderson looking for the screen, but losing his balance, blew the screen. Is jumped third down and 8 now from the Florida 38. Troy Aikman got a man hitting. That is Willie Anderson, who came back to the ball, coming off a shoulder separation, and frankly, a little surprised to see him this early in the game.
Well, we were told that he probably wouldn't play, but coaches do strange things when they get in ball games.
That wasn't
the first time he's had a chance of being out for any length of time, and he came right back. Perfectly fine. He got a little dazed in that last play that sent him out of the ball game. They expect him to go back in.
The Hula Bowl, 1971. I'm not sure he ever went home. This is Eric Ball turning the corner, gets to the 20, down to the 19. Third and 3, the Bruins. Gives it up the middle, goes Ball, and they've stopped him. This one is put down at the 24, so it's a 34-yard effort. A little light, misty rain starting to fall. The wind is not a factor. The kick is up and good. UCLA 3-0. Going down the right side to Williams. Again, he's got some room. And another fine return by Wayne Williams out to about the 30-yard line. Emmett Smith, the deep man, has the ball. Got a good block to spring him at the line of scrimmage. Watch him skate through there. He's a great traffic runner for a freshman. And he's up to the 45-yard line. And the Gators have a first down. Trailing the Bruins 3-0 here in the first quarter of play. Kerman Bell shoots one to the sidelines. Passes into the arms of Willie Sneed. And he clutches it as he's knocked out of bounds.
With the absence of Ricky Natia this year.
Non-scholarship. This is Smith bouncing outside. Gets away from Chance Johnson and is brought down around the 25.
But you just don't bring him down the first time you hit him.
Mugging right there of Willie McGrady by Ken Norton. And on it, make it third down and four now for the Bruins. Or for the Gators, excuse me. Herman Bell loops one, got a man wide open out of the backfield. It's Willie McGrady, the fullback. Alan Dial brought him down. It's first down, Florida. Brad Bresson now is into the ball game, replacing Gibby Jim Waller. This is Smith to the outside and inside the 10. Florida now with a serious threat. Second down, 2.5. Inside the 10, hand the ball to McGrady. He's to the 5, across it to the 3, and it's first and goal Gators. Oh, we're going to play some old-fashioned jawbone football right here as the quarterback stepped on, hands the ball to Smith, and Smith canters into the end zone, but they're going to, I think, mark him down. Ball comes back near the 7-yard line. They go to double wide receivers now on the bottom of the picture and loop it into the corner of the end zone, and it is out of bounds. Incomplete. Intended and caught for. Caught by Ernie Mills, but... And it is third and goal from the 7. Bell throwing again. In the corner. Defender on the corner.
Kind of zone. I'm guarding the area, not the man.
Robert McGinty is 34 for 34 this season in extra points. And so the Florida Gators, stung by the UCLA field goal, come back to take the lead 7-3. Sun pops out bright now. And McGinty hangs it up there. Back at the 6. It's called a fair catch. Almost, but he's coming back. The 40 to the 41. The official almost calling for the fair catch. Of course, you can do that. And involved in
dead ball, encroachment, defense.
Cost a little swinging gate here. That's what some folks call it. Ball is snapped directly to Eric Ball, and Ball didn't really fool a whole lot of Gators. Gain was close to 6 yards as Aikman drops to throw it and goes deep with it. It's a foot race to the corner. Intended for Paco Craig.
And Lewis Oliver.
Bruins go to the shotgun now on third down and 4.5. Three wideouts. Aikman has time. Underneath with it. The pass is incomplete. Rotation on the ball is up. Really zips it. Some pressure on the punter, Barkate, but Harold gets it out of there, hangs it up. Lou Breeze picks it and drops it straight down. And Wayne Williams and Anthony Williams are the setbacks now for Florida. Wayne being the high back has the ball, comes right up the middle. And he goes from the 13-yard line up close to the 17. Second down and about 5. Kerwin Bell hands it off to Anthony Williams, and he's going to have a first down. Gets it up across the 25. First down for the Gators, just over the 25. Bell to the sidelines, just beyond the marker. Ball is caught by Willie Sneed.
We have to mix the pass and the run.
They go back to Wayne Williams. And he's got another Florida first down as he... So the Gators leading 7-3 in third possession of the ball game, looking to stick it in the end zone again. And Kerwin Bell getting pressure. pressure. 2:21 to go in the first quarter. Emmett Smith is back into the game now for the Gators. Second down and 10, and Emmett's got the ball. He may be as good as any freshman I can remember at work. Six carries and 50 yards here in the first quarter. For Emmett Smith, they go to the big man, Anthony Williams,
and that was the case.
Herbert Perry is in the punt. He's a freshman. He's probably the quarterback of the future at Florida. Knuckleballs one down, and he kills it down inside the 20. That's UCLA. They're going to give him a little more of the bounce back up field and put it at the 21-yard line. Troy Aikman pitches the ball late to Eric Ball. Gator defense is tough, as you can see. Second down and 10, Bruins. Aikman. He completes it to Paco Craig. 5'10", 175. Brian Brown is now in the backfield for the Bruins on first down. They work out of the shotgun. Give it to Brown. Brown took a pretty good lick from number 40, Gerald Dickin. First quarter's over. And so after the first 15 minutes in the Eagle Aloha Bowl in Hawaii, it's Florida 7 and UCLA 3. Ames is not altogether healthy. Brown is the other back. Aikman's pass is thrown complete. Caught by Corbin Anthony, the tight end, for a first down. Here, first down and 10 for UCLA. The ball at their own 48-yard line. Handed inside to the up man, Mark Eastrick, a 220-pound. Aikman checking off, changing the play. On a throw, loops it over the head of the Florida defenders. Third and 7. Out of the shotgun, Aikman gets some pressure from Charlton. He's got to hold it and takes him down. Clifford Charlton, the senior outside backer. No pressure this time, and Barkate shoots a dandy. Ooh, that's a good one. All the way back to the 10, and a fair catch. Join the children. First down for the Florida Gators from their 10. Give the ball to Emmett Smith. And gain of a yard, second down 9 for the Gators. Bell rolls it out, buys a little time, and then underthrows his target.
Both wide starting wide receivers were at other positions last year.
Third and 9. Pressure's on. Loads it, got it out of there, and saved the sack here. Otherwise, UCLA is going to have the ball on the Florida side of the field. He got it up, got some hang time, and forced the fair catch. Eric Ball and James Priest in the I formation with Aikman the quarterback. Bring the tight end in motion, and Aikman throws low and underneath, and he was getting heat. Estrick is back into the ball game at fullback for the Bruins. Hasn't played much this year. Second down and 10. UCLA go to the shotgun. Give it to Eric Ball. And Ball is run down from behind by number 54, Mark Murray. And it's third and 7 for the Bruins. Aikman going to run out of time. Charlton got him. Charlton went all the way around. It looks like we've got a new punter. It's Kurt Maggio.
They blocked it.
They blocked it. And the Gators have it at the 48-yard line. So, the Barkate, the regular punter, not out there. And the Gators are cooking now at their 48. Leading in the ball game 7-3. As Bell drops the throw on first down. Down the middle, got it. That is Willie Sneed. And he's inside the 20. And it's first down at the UCLA 19-yard line. Give the ball to Wayne Williams. Runs hard to the 14. Terry Donahue facing the sideline. Bell back to Williams. At the line of scrimmage. Third down and a little more than 5. Stay with the ground game. Back to Wayne Williams and UCLA's defensive bunch up front. He'll hit it from the 23. It'll officially go as a 22, 32-yard kick. It's way up in the air, and it's plenty long. And so the Florida Gators now extend their margin over the UCLA Bruins to 7. With 9 minutes to play in the first half, it's 10-3 Gators. Well, he knocks it, doesn't he? That's about four or five yards deep into the end zone. They'll bring it back to the 20.
Patriots are glad to have him.
You bet.
First down and 10 from the 20. Aikman gives it to Eric Ball, working his way in the middle and is close to a first down. Second down and a short yard for the Bruins. Aikman changing his play. He may want to go a little big here. One second to short. Nope, he'll go for the first down. And that's what he gets out of the 32.
I'd rather see that than have a quick flag. They're forcing the judgment onto the officials. The judgment calls.
Third down and 8. Pressure, Charlton. Second quarterback sack for Clifford Charlton. The punter, Kirk Maggio, tried it well ago and got it stuffed. Arcade shoots it out of there, and it's a beauty. Coming back to Jarvis Williams at the 26. And he found some daylight and brings it back to the 40. Well, the setbacks behind Kerwin Bell. This is Emmitt Smith. Second down and 4. Well, with play action, has a lot of time. And the pass is caught by Mark McGriff.
And he was open. He doesn't lose his balance. He can run another 10 yards.
Pressure on Bell, and running him down from the outside is Ben Huddle.
Because of the injuries, he's finally getting an opportunity to play.
They've got Emmitt Smith in motion this time. Bell goes down the middle, got a man wide open, and he missed it. Clifton Reynolds, the tight end. Florida's 1 out of 5 on their third down conversion so far. It's the same alignment, the same motion. Deeper drop by Kerwin Bell, and UCLA drops to cover. It's going to be a coverage sack if they get him, and I think Florida might get dinged right here for a holding call because it took forever to tie it.
Holding on the offense. Penalty is declined. Fourth down.
Kicks it away from Henley, comes across and signals fair catch. Pretty good football coach.
Yes, he is. Huh.
Nell Farr shows up at tight end now for UCLA as they hand the ball off to Brian Brown. Four, it's a pickup of close to 5. So it'll be second down. Bruins have run for under 32 yards of the ball game. Florida has 101. They're working out of the shotgun and looped the pass downfield. Willie Anderson out of bounds. To the shotgun, third down, close to 6. Aikman gets a little heat, flips it off inside, and then a shovel pass to James Primus. James picks up a first down.
That's why you bring that up.
Aikman back to throw it. Troy pumps it up and shoots it. Anderson too high.
Florida has only given up 8 touchdown passes in the last 28 games, so they're pretty stingy.
Mike Farr, money receiver, came onto the field, but they go to the run.
And we're going to come out with our fast break offense in the second half. Well, that remains to be seen.
Third and 9. Aikman gets away from the heat, throws the pass. Oh, what an outstanding catch by Joe Pickard, the senior tight end.
And the things that you never see.
Yeah.
Everybody follows the football.
That's right. This is Brian Brown. Second and about 8. Set up the screen outside for Willie Anderson. Got the block, and here he goes. Down to the 23-yard line.
I think it was Oliver that Richards buried, and of course, Richards weighs better than 300 pounds. Lewis is probably saying, get off.
Richards says, that's a long way for me to run.
Brian Brown behind the right guard. It's cool today. It's not a hot day. Very, very comfortable day.
Up here, nice breeze.
It's not so bad down below either. As the pass shot and caught to Willie Anderson. And
against the defense, first down.
Really, you couldn't see the flag from where we are, but we knew there was something going on. And here go the Bruins now. As Aikman rolls it, and throws it out of bounds. Incomplete in 16 seconds. left to play in the first half. Florida leading 10-3. Aikman shoots it. Pass is good to Brown. He stopped on the one. What a great tackle. James Primus and Brian Brown, the backs, as very well could be the last play of the first half. And so with 3 seconds to play, I don't know how in the world they kept three up on the clock, but they did. You're all even. You'll enjoy. Scoots it down on the ground, bouncing around. It's finally picked up by Wayne Williams. Time has expired. And so has Wayne. So we go to the locker room. All even at halftime in the Eagle Aloha Bowl from Hawaii. Bruins 10 and the Gators 10. And it's a very comfortable, cool day in Hawaii. And we have the halftime show for you in just a moment. With 30 minutes to play. And Florida kicks it off. McGinney with that strong leg drives it to the goal line. Brian Brown has it. Football and the Bruins recover it. Number 15, Danny Thompson. And here we go, first down from the 24 with Aikman, the quarterback. Ball and Estwick lined up in the backfield behind him, and it's Eric Ball. And Eric has a couple of yards. The Bruins call it second down, about 8. Aikman goes to the outside. There's a hit by Jarvis Williams on...
I'll tell you what, Troy Aikman spreading Christmas gifts around. That's the 8th man to have caught a ball today.
That was no gift. No, as far as Eswick was concerned, the way he got hit.
Aikman can't find anybody downfield, so he goes underneath to Joe Pickard to tie it in. Who went... In Japan. They started at 5:30 a.m. Tokyo time. UCLA first down. Go to Eric Ball on the first down snap from the 44-yard line. Second down and 9 from the 43. It was Ball. And Eric Ball gets nailed.
And they sing pretty well too, right? Let's hear it.
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh.
It's hardly a time to be singing.
That's for sure.
We're in UCLA colors because Kerry Watkins just picked that one off.
Watkins gets an opportunity to play and makes a big interception.
And Bell hands the ball to Emmett Smith, and he dances to the outside. Now he's going the other way. Carnell Lake missed him but slowed him down.
And deciding, but that game decided who went to the Rose Bowl. Southern Cal went.
Second down and 8. Bell throwing the ball. Sideline calling, and he's lucky to get that one back because it was clearly in the hands. And
Kerwin Bell has done a nice job in keeping it away from those defensive backs in the first half.
Florida had 6 and third down conversions. Deep drop by Bell. Now it takes off. Kerwin is not the swiftest of the swift, but he knows where the yardage marker's there, and he stretches out and picks up a first down. But
Bill, it's a lot safer up here in the booth.
Drop the ball. They try to run a reverse, and Emmett Smith, it looked like, took his eyes off the intended receiver there in a handoff, and the ball came loose, and now UCLA with opportunity at their own 49. Aikman doesn't give up too many interceptions. Charlton loops from the outside. Look at that. I say he doesn't give up many interceptions, and bingo. He's thrown 2 in the last minute.
That one by Gerald Dickens.
And we had no intercept, no turnovers the first half. In the last, we've had three in the first few minutes of the third quarter.
Here's Emmett Smith again. He fumbles the football, and UCLA's got it. Can you believe it? I think they greased those things at halftime. Well, he said, told me the other night that he was going to get one, and by gosh, he did. Now they're on the Florida 46-yard line. Take it inside with Primus, the fullback. They said the other night, second down and 8. All just short of the Florida 44. Garrett Ball. And Ball will turn it for a yard or two. The ball is resting at the 43 now of Florida. UCLA's possession, third and long here, 3rd and 7. Aikman looked at far and didn't have time. They ate him up. Henry Brown and Huey Richardson got it. Got some heat on him, knocked him down, and there's your flag. He did not touch the ball. Williams is down at the 15, but they're going to bring that one back. Steve Loden.
They almost blocked one in the first quarter. Blocked one then just before halftime. And now you get the call that you don't do much.
Against
get possession
the defense,
back.
5-yard penalty is declined. First down.
It is not that hot down on that field. Bell drops. Little quick pop out to the side. Goes to Stacy Simmons. And Simmons works his way up to around the 25.
Because of more games in the conference?
Yes, sir. That was the reason for that change.
Ball is given this time to Willie McGrady. And Willie's going to have a first down. Having a party in Calgary here on ABC. Back goes Bell. All day this time. And again goes to Simmons. And he gets shirt-tailed up around the 30, 36-yard line. Since their last game in 1958. Smith picking his way, and a penalty flag is thrown.
This is really the first week I've watched practice every week. I did.
That Bob Grecio is your great debt because your defensive unit with the Miami Dolphins got him the ball a lot, so he could do what he did for the offense. Down deep on the sideline, Simmons running with Dennis Price.
Hustle the ball right down the middle, trying to hit a receiver on a square end, and hit Bill right in the side of the head.
I remember that.
With 4.5 minutes to go in the third quarter, the score tied at 10-10. First down. We got Smith in motion. And Bell shoots one. Did he have it? No. No completion.
For 6 players off of their defense on the first or second team of the Pac-10 defense.
Smith with it. Missed in the backfield. Look at it. Pretty clever, isn't he? And very, very strong.
On the tackle, 5-yard face mask against the defense, first down.
Florida was hit with a dead ball, personal foul. And that makes it the 1st and 25 with McGrady and Williams in the backfield. And that pass is incomplete, intended for Clifton Reynolds. McGrady now, the long remaining back as Florida goes to 3 wideouts. Bell has some time and goes down the middle. Off the hands of Willie Sneed. Well, Willie has made 3 good catches,
but that one certainly was not his fault. It was on the money.
3rd and 25. Loads it up. And incomplete. Intended for Tony Lomax. 4th of the day. His longest 24 yards. Right up the middle. They block it. Bruins block it. And have the football. And he's on the Florida 20. David Keating, a sophomore flanker, came right up the middle for UCLA, and they returned the favor. Trying to break the 10-10 tie in the late moments of the third quarter. That's Eric Ball, and he isn't going anywhere. Willie Anderson is the wide man at the top. They go that way with it. They want to throw it to him, and he's got double coverage, and he needs some help there, and they'll agree to fill the gap, playing very sorely. Aikman back. Throws it out. Pass caught by Pickard. Pickard dives inside the marker. First down. UCLA at the Florida 4. And
couple of other changes in the lineup as well. On first down and goal, to Eric Ball, and there is a solid lick by Jarvis Williams. UCLA has run the ball 31 times in the game, picked up 36 yards. That's all. Second down and goal, now back out by the six-yard line, and Aikman looks into the end zone. Looks at Thompson, throws for Thompson, he caught it, touchdown!
Well, the key here is he's outside the pocket and he's got all kinds of time to throw. His mobility gives him an opportunity to throw the football. It bounces in the air.
Velasco for the extra point. Penalty flag, it's good. Let's see about the flag. Now bring him back out to the 15. Left to kick 25 yards for Alfredo Velasco. And he's pretty good. That close to the goal line. 17-10. UCLA gets the lead. Good kick. Oh, got to catch it first, Wayne. Fake the reverse. Williams kept it. Finds daylight. And penalty flags flying as he comes all the way back to the 47-yard line.
On the return, clipping against Florida, half a distance, first down.
To the 13-yard line. Emmitt Smith is back in the backfield with Anthony Williams. Anthony Williams has been fun to watch today. I'll tell you something. He lays some blocks out there. He's one of the reasons that Smith is doing things like this. And he's up across the 35, and a penalty flag is thrown.
Net right there. Smith, 22, just using his talents.
This is Wayne Williams, and he finds 9 yards. Darrell Woolley is the wide man at the bottom of the picture. Time running out in the third quarter. Go back to Smith. Look at him pick his way through there. Penalty flag as he goes down. So we got 1 quarter to go at the Eagle Aloha Bowl in Hawaii. And the UCLA Bruins have the lead over Florida, 17-10. Penalties. 42 negative yards for them. Second down right now for the Gators and 11. And Bell throws underneath. The pass is incomplete. Intended for Stacy Simmons.
Possessions this half.
Florida trying to cover it. No chance. Johnson's got it for UCLA. Florida man took a swipe at it and Johnson got it. Troy Aikman to Brian Brown. To the 5. Running back by trade normally. And he's in motion. Pitch it to Brown. Good block on the corner to the, about the 3. That will be a first down.
And thanks Santa there, Rocky. He paid for the whole trip, the father. Keep.
Yeah. Oh, man, he's working today, right? Hand off to Brown. Up the middle he goes. To the goal line, but not in. Second and goal at the 1. Brown over the top. Penalty flag. He did not break the plane.
Ball was loose, too.
That flag came early.
Florida's had the ball 4 possessions and have had 3 fumbles to turn the ball over.
So the ball comes back to the 6. We're at second down and goal. Aikman rolls it out. Gets sacked back at the 17-yard line by Jeff Roth. Marked down. And it's third down and goal. Aikman hands to Brown, bounces outside, and a run down by number 24, Bill Lang. Alfredo Velasco. He's kicked a 34-yarder for the opening scoring in the game. This one from 32 yards and good. So 11:06 to play in the game, and the Bruins by 10.
Maybe the SEC would go out and beat a Pac-10 team, one of the better ones, and UCLA was 9-2. That would mean something.
Nicolet Joey Nicolet comes down with the football, and we have a fracas.
11:06 to play. Let the other team get the ball in that kind of field position.
And they have to start first at 25 back at their own 34-yard line. Bell has to pull it down. Now he dumps it off to, tries to dump it off to Smith. Especially when you're playing on this artificial surface. Driving over. Sherman Bell now out of the shotgun. Gets his pass away. The pass is caught by Clifton Reynolds. They've been trying to get the ball to Clifton.
Dead ball, personal foul with the helmet against the defense. Automatic first down.
And a half, 57 before this series of plays in the penalty yards. 67. This is Emmett Smith. Problem still growing. He's got 116 yards now on 14 carries. Bell gives it back to him. Up the middle he goes. Somebody got his shirt tail. That's a tearaway jersey like we used to have back in the 50s and 60s. I'm thinking, of course, some growing pains with Air Supply, Maureen McGovern, and many more. Starting at 2:30 Central Time here on ABC Sports, this is Smith. It might last into the night. Wayne Williams has been in and out of the ball game. He's back in there now, and will get nothing up.
UCLA
20-10. Bruins have the lead over the Gators. The Gators trying to get one back now. It's third down and six. Herman Bell gets it off. Pass is caught by Walter Odom. And Odom will have a first down for Florida at the UCLA 15-yard line.
Before he had all those problems.
Emmett Smith is back in now. A tailback on first down. Has the ball. Starts up the middle and picks up a yard. Well, the editor's probably chewing on this. Wide open, 36, Anthony Williams, touchdown. Penalty flag on the field, hold it.
We have a touchdown and a dead ball, unsportsmanlike conduct foul against the offense to be assessed on the kickoff.
Touchdown in the backfield either.
The extra point try is blocked by McGinty. He got his foot on it, but the Bruins came flying in. I don't know who it was. Toomey, I think, number 40, because he was the man standing closest to the kicker.
And have to score a touchdown to get back in the game otherwise.
Got that flag. It was the eighth flag. That kick is going to go. Oh, you should have left it alone. It was right on the chalk, and Brian gambled and made the catch of it and almost teetered out of bounds. Willie Anderson with a little bit of hitch in his get-along is out there. He's limping just a little bit. But he's out there. And Eric Ball isn't going anywhere on that kick. Second down, call it eight. Reggie Moore. And they give it to Eric Ball. A good cutback by Eric. Picks up about 4 yards on that carry.
The linebackers, if they have a weakness, is what it is.
Bit of a key play here. On third down and four. Aikman back. Down the middle. Pass caught by Mike Farr in traffic. And Mike will pick up a first down for UCLA.
Outstanding linebacker.
From the 46. Give it to Eric Ball, tries to bounce outside and loses a yard, goes down at the 45. This is Aikman. Oh, he ran right on past Brown, who was his protector on that rollout.
They'll lose Gaston Green and Mel Farr, but the nucleus of their talent, skill positions, are back offensively.
That's Brown in motion. Aikman gets a little heat, but gets the pass off. Brown goes to the turf with it, and apparently held it. Florida's going to get off a good field position. The Bruins have gained 48 yards and 40 rushes of the ball. Eric Ball, he got it.
UCLA's got enough points to win. They just want to take time off the clock.
They got Doug Wassel, the backup center. He's in there at guard right now. He was the pulling man on that play. Ball again. They'll stay on the ground with it. Florida's going to get him behind the line of scrimmage. Aikman's going to put it up. And hits his man, number 20, Mark Estrick. Bruins lead by four. Gators trying to stop them. UCLA shotgun. Aikman tries to go inside with that little flip to Primus, and the Gators eat it up. So Terragana, you're not giving him a confidence builder. And he hits a knuckleball up, and he's going to be successful with what he had in mind. I'm having a chance to pull it out. It's a four-point lead. 20-16. They'll start on the shotgun. Bell's pass to the sideline. Good to Emmett Smith.
Instead of a loss.
Second and three. That's good for the first down. Caught by Walter Odom. See, the Gators have had their successes against West Coast schools. Now Bell gets some heat. Goes underneath to Smith to the 30. It's so hard to get a whole grip on.
If you were the quarterback, you'd want to get it to him. Just little flares out of the backfield.
There's another one. And he's close to his first down. 1:36 to play in the game. Herman Bell has hit seven of his last seven. There's your first down with Wayne Williams carrying. That stops your clock. Staying in the shotgun. Oh, Smith almost took off too soon. They get away with it. And the ball ricocheting around.
Quarterbacks, he's at the controls.
He got 57 now, doesn't he? Total.
Yep.
He has a lot of time and finally throws, and it is caught by Odom for a first down. If he doesn't lose his balance, he really makes a big play out of it. Penalty flag out of the referee's pocket. The pass is caught by Darrell Woolard on the far sideline. But it's going to be penalty against Florida.
Call the play.
We talked about the psychology. This game could have gone a number of ways, and it has turned out to be a very good football game.
Pass to Emmett Smith. He gets a block. And he goes down around the 43-yard line. Ball at the UCLA 42, 35 seconds. Bell's got to kill the clock now. Throws it to the sidelines, and it is caught. Caught by Ernie Mills, and Mills gets to the sideline. Bell's got a problem. Gets it away, and it is incomplete. Second and 10. Again, Hummel is loose. Bell sidearms it out of bounds, incomplete. And takes the lick from Ben Hummel. The Bruins are moving in some classy company right there. Low snap. Bell runs away from the pressure. He's got a long way to run. He's got to get out of bounds, and he does. Down at the UCLA 20. And you've got 5 seconds to play. Goes up under center this time. The Bruins blitz up the middle. Bell steps away from it. Throws it into the end zone, and it is incomplete. The ball game is over. It was intended for Darrell Woolard, defended by Darrell Hindley. And your final score, UCLA 20 and Florida 16.